Here's a group of three stars in a triangle. They remind me of the nose cone of a rocket ship. Is that a constellation? Here is a cup shape with a long handle. It's not the Big Dipper, but it's a shape in the stars. Is it a constellation? If you want to make up a shape and call it a constellation, that's fine with me. The word constellation comes from roots that mean group of stars. But I know a lot of astronomy educators who say, no, 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 those aren't constellations. You could call them asterisms if you want. The roots of the word asterism mean star thing. I guess, like a lot of words in English, the word constellation means more than one thing. Let's explore a little bit. The desktop planetarium program Stellarium is showing us the sky for the middle of May, and there are a lot of ways to put the stars together into groups. One way is to imagine you're connecting the dots. This is one way that the stars can be connected by lines. This group of stars is Leo. One of my favorites is a little rectangle here, well, it's kind of squashed, called Corvus. Check this out. Someone saw a zigzag here and said, let's make a long, snaky shape. That one's called Hydra. Now, these names come from stories that aren't about sticks that join stars, but they're about characters in the sky. So another way to imagine the stars is as shapes. Adding shapes to the sky, I can see that the group that I called Leo a moment ago can be pictured as a lion. The ones that connected to make that zigzag shape could be like a water snake, that's Hydra. And the one I said I liked here, like a squished box, that's Corvus, the crow. My neighborhood has too many crows, they crowd out the other birds, but they're fun to watch. These shapes are invented by people, and people have invented them different ways. Let's look at another way to consider constellations. People use constellations to describe where things are in the sky. So the International Astronomical Union decided we need a system of boundaries so everyone can agree on what's a part of one constellation and what's part of another constellation. So this boundary around Leo shows me that the stars and the galaxies and the nebulae, everything that is in that part of the sky, you could call part of Leo. A constellation in this sense isn't simply a group of stars, it's a region of the sky. And this is the sense of constellations that's the most precise. Still, it's an invention of humans, like the boundaries of countries on a map. It's not a scientific discovery. It's a choice people have made. There are 88 constellations, or 89, depending on how you count them. Now you'd think there wouldn't be any difficulty in dividing up the sky into a bunch of regions and knowing how many regions you've divided it up into. But consider this. A region of the sky called Ophiuchus is here. Ophiuchus in the old stories is the snake holder. And the head of the snake is here. And the tail of the snake is here. The head and the tail of the snake are often considered one constellation, even though they're not attached. It reminds me of President Grover Cleveland. He was president twice. Does he count as one president or two presidents? Usually he's counted as two, but in general, people count the two parts of the snake, even though they're separate, as one constellation, which makes 88. But I think 89 would make more sense. So now we have a more precise idea of what a constellation can be. We can ask questions like, what's the biggest constellation? Well, look at that water snake, Hydra. It goes on and on and on. Of all the constellations in the night sky, Hydra is the one that takes up the most space. And the end of spring, beginning of the summer is one of the best times to see Hydra, right in the south. But you notice it doesn't have bright stars in it. When I'm looking for Hydra, sometimes I look for the lion and then look down below it, or I look for my favorite little group, Corvus the Crow, which has fairly bright stars, and I know that Hydra is under it. So I use the little constellation to find the big constellation. Or you might say the biggest constellation is the one with the most bright stars in it. I was wondering which ones that was as well. And I knew Orion has bright stars. And so let's look at Orion. I'm showing only the top few dozen brightest stars, and seven of them are within the boundaries of Orion, and that's the most of any constellation. You won't see Orion at the end of spring or into summer, because this time of year it goes down with the sun. Coming in second for the constellation with the most bright stars is Ursa Major, with six bright stars. And these do make the cup with the long handle that is the asterism that people call the Big Dipper. The Big Dipper, Ursa Major, is visible all spring and summer high in the sky. And you could imagine it's a bear that's upside down. Tied with Ursa Major in second place for the constellation with the most bright stars is Scorpius with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bright stars that make a curly tail of a scorpion. That's what you can imagine. Well, what about the constellation with the most stars overall, not just the bright ones? If you're talking about all the stars in the universe, I have no idea which constellation has the most. But if you're talking about the one with the most stars that are part of our galaxy, the Milky Way, then it's got to be Sagittarius. In this little corner of Sagittarius, you're looking at the center of the Milky Way galaxy. This diagram of the Milky Way galaxy shows it as a big disk of stars with a dense core. Stars are much more closely spaced together there. The sun is in this part of the galaxy, so if we're looking towards Sagittarius, we're looking toward a lot of stars. You're not going to see them all, though. Mostly they're the kind of stars that are too faint to show up. And there's a lot of dusty stuff blocking the light from a lot of those stars. And they're just really far away. So there's a group of stars, the Milky Way galaxy. Would I call that a constellation? No, that's too big a stretch. So the most precise idea of what a constellation is a region of the sky and everything in it. Or your mind can be creative, and a constellation for you could be a shape or a character in a story in the sky. But to recognize those shapes, it's helpful to connect the dots in ways that make sense to you. So take a look at the sky in spring and find some constellations, ones you make up yourself, or some of the ones that we all share, like the lion here, the snaky water monster here, or the little crow right down here. Good luck.